This icon means that it's a licensed event. Licensed events offer different experiences based on your chosen license level. Respectful driving grants access to higher license levels, but incurring warnings and penalties will limit the range of licenses you can use. You can choose which license to drive under from those you have access to. Driving under higher level licenses will deliver a more authentic F1 experience. There are bonuses and benefits to driving under a higher license level. So to progress efficiently in F1 world, it's worth trying to gain a higher license.
Welcome along, everybody, to our latest F1 World event. There might just be a single prize for victory, but there are so many stories up and down the grid as our drivers look to make a name for themselves. The Spielberg circuit then is situated 700 meters above sea level, with just 10 corners making up one of the shortest laps of the season. One time around here is a distance of around 2.6 miles, with the best overtaking chances into turn one or the tight uphill of turn three. High up in the Austrian Alps, here we are at Spielberg, as these drivers line up under the watchful eye of the giant steel bull. The history of this track, the legacy of Red Bull, and the Red Bull ring really need no introductions.
Yeah.
fastest lap of the race so far. That look so easy. It was nice and clean, and we took that victory. A fantastic team effort then to secure victory here in the Styrian Alps. Well, Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today, but what set them apart from the rest?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. races, so many stories. Who knows what the next chapter has in store for us all? So join us next time out for more thrilling F1 world action. World action for you today, so welcome along, ladies and gentlemen, and pick your favourite driver to follow. Straddling the border of Northamptonshire and Buckinghamshire, the 18 corners of Silverstone Circuit form the 3.6 mile beating heart of Formula One. It's been reinvented over the years, with Turn 1 now the fast right-hander of Abbey, but the magic of racing is as strong here as it's ever been. Some really technical terms coming up for our drivers today. Maggots, Becketts, Chappell, making that unforgettable triple header. And of course, then there's the high-speed cops. The first battle is keeping it together on the track, and there are positions to be gained and made here. for the race, final lap. It wasn't always plain sailing today, but it was a very important win nonetheless. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race. Format for me, it might be a new format for you as well, but there's no doubting that the action comes thick and fast in F1 world. I can't wait for the next time. World action for you today. Welcome along, everybody, as we look down at our grid. Who's your driver to follow? Spa-Francorchamps then, a historic 19-corner circuit with a lap distance of 4.35 miles. There's over 100 metres of elevation change here, and with long stretches of the lap spent flat out, a good top speed will be vital for success. And as our drivers line up on the grid, looking into the distance and the hairpin at La Source, they'll all be thinking how to exit that corner and to make their way through Eau Rouge and up Radion unscathed without conceding track position.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. stuff. Keep it going. In here on the pit wall. That was super clean and we got the win.
What a great race then, and a magnificent victory here at the Belgian Grand Prix. Well, Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today. But what set them apart from the rest?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way onto the podium now. we've gone wheel to wheel, we've seen thrills and spills. Who knows what's coming next? So join us again for more F1 World Action. It's a full house and it's a full grid as our latest F1 World event is just moments away. So have you picked your favourite driver to cheer on? With top speeds up to 215 and an average lap speed of around 155 miles per hour, Monza's reputation as one of the fastest circuits in the sport is well earned. We have 11 corners on this 3.6 mile track, with the best overtaking chance coming into the heavy braking zone of the Turn 1 chicane. As the drivers finish their grid preparations, looking out for the famous chicane at turns 1 and 2, they'll know it's very easy to lose control and grid position, but also it's possible to gain it too.
laps in a row. Beautiful stuff. Keep it going. Okay, we've been given a time penalty. It will go against our finishing time at the end of the race. Get your head down and let's get it done. The win, and it was super clean. That was a joy to watch.
Here we are then, a thoroughly deserved win in Italy after another excellent Grand Prix. Well, Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today, but what set them apart from the rest?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Well, what a thrilling end to an incredible Grand Prix weekend. Our top three finishers should be incredibly happy with what they were able to achieve out there today. Where you start, it's where you finish. So even though it might have been a disappointing start to the season for some, there's plenty of time to rise through the rankings as we continue in F1 World. more F1 World action for you today. Welcome along, everybody, as we look down at our grid. Who's your driver to follow? Miles of track at Imola featuring 19 turns, 9 to the right and 10 to the left. Remember that Imola differs from most other Formula One tracks as it's taken anti-clockwise. Let's hope nobody forgets that today. The exit from turn 18 will probably be the setup for many of today's overtakes, leading as it does into the longest straight on the circuit, and it's only DRS zone. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. Our F1 World drivers have had many ups and downs as they progress to this moment in their F1 World journey. But who will taste victory today? Who will go home empty-handed? Lap gets underway then, and it's going to be interesting today to see how the dry conditions can affect the lifespan of the tyres. We're almost ready to start the race as the cars take their positions on the grid, with the drivers and teams making their final preparations.
Thank you.
done.
window's open, so let's box this lap, box this lap. To worry about the tyre condition for now, everything's looking good.
Out in the lane and ready to perform their magic on the car. They're going to be aiming to achieve the fastest pit stop time possible.
After these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. Okay to use your overtake button. Right, you've been pushing your luck on track limits too much and we've been given a 3-second penalty. So the gap to the car ahead, 18.2 seconds. 5 laps of fuel remaining.
We'll be right back.
a clean win. Great stuff, mate. That is going to do your progression wonders.
It's a performance that our Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix winners can be justifiably proud of. And I'm sure there'll be celebrations tonight. Anthony Davidson, what helped them deliver this result, do you think?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Here comes your top three making their way down to the podium for what can only be described as a fantastic day for Formula One. For some, less so for others. But who knows, the tables might turn next time out. Plenty more races to come this season, so join us again. It's F1 World.
Thank you. Thank you. not just F1 cars that make you a circuit. official name of this circuit, Formula 1 Switzerland.